Hi everyone, today I'm going to show you something I've found from the past. So it's actually my CV that got me an interview at Google and eventually got me a job at Datacom where I work currently. So first off, it's a very simple CV. I didn't have much to put on it because I was a grad at the time. So it's quite good to give you an idea of what to put in a CV if you're just sort of starting out and looking for your first job. First, I just put all my name and contact details so it's easy for them to get in contact with me. And then I provided a bit about my educational background. I only really included university because I didn't think the rest was relevant. But for some places, I know that high school is relevant. So if you're in one of those places, feel free to include it. I just didn't feel it was necessary for me. So I talked a bit about my experience. So this was just different projects I had worked on because I hadn't been employed at this stage. So first I talked about a game I had developed, which was an Android application. And basically it was a replica of the Snake game that was available on the Nokia phones. So everyone really around my millennial age would understand what that game is. And basically you're trying to eat pieces of food and your snake tail grows and you're trying to get as much food as possible. So I described a little bit about that, and I also include some future expansion ideas. I don't really think that was beneficial in any way, but I guess I included it to show I've had sort of future thoughts and creativity there. And I also included a little bit about what the app was developed using, so the tools I used, so IntelliJ, GitHub, and that it was developed on Ubuntu. I think the main thing that drew Google's attention was that for my final year project, me and my partner worked on an information mashups web tool, where we basically did some natural language processing of user input, very similar to what Google does when you type in their search box. And then from there it would display different data sets on a map to sort of try and answer different questions that the user might have. So it might be like, I want to find a house in a good school area, and it would pop up some different school areas and some different house listings available. So it was pulling data from lots of different areas and just aggregating that data on a map. And I think that's what stood out to Google, particularly the natural language processing, which was using the Python natural language toolkit. That's quite an easy toolkit to use, but yeah, I think if you're targeting specifically wanting to work at places like Google, you're gonna want to have a project that's got some sort of natural language processing or machine learning or something to do with data science, because that's a sort of key part of what they do. So I think this really drew their attention, and that's why they were interested in me. I did go on to do a few over the phone interviews with them, but I wasn't hired by them. I ended up, I think, doing 3 over the phone interviews before I sort of failed one. But yeah, that was as a grad, so you know, move on. I also listed out some of my technical strengths, so the languages that I felt comfortable in, and I just did them in the order of how comfortable I was in them. So my primary language at the time was Java, then Python, JavaScript, HTML, CSS, and then I sort of listed tools in the order that I was familiar with them as well. And I also listed what my main operating system at the time was, which is Ubuntu, but I've since moved on. I use Windows for work and Mac for my personal life, as you can tell from all my videos. So then I also included a little bit of additional information. I wanted to show that I had commitments outside of uni that I'd been successful in, and that I sort of had a diverse range of interests and could succeed in multiple things. I think it's important to show that you're well-rounded as an individual. And so that's why I put a little bit about my achievements in curling, which was my favourite sport at the time. I'm now into lawn bowls as well, but I still love curling. So yeah, my first CV, it was very simple, and I actually wrote it in this program called LaTeX. So basically it's like you use a text editor, and I found some CV templates, and then you just build it through the command line. So yeah, I found some CV templates, just sort of filled it out. I kept it pretty simple. It doesn't matter too much what your CV looks like for software roles, because they're not really testing your creativity, unless you're going for like a front-end role maybe, or a UI role, then you might want to spend a little bit more time making your CV a bit more pretty so that you stand out to the people that are trying to hire for that particular role. But from a purely development perspective, as long as you've got the information there and it's easy to see, I think that's all you really need. I tried to keep mine short. I didn't really have a lot to add anyway because I didn't have much experience. But yeah, I tried to elaborate as much as possible on the projects I had worked on throughout my years at uni. And yeah, I really hope this helps you searching for your next job or searching for your first job out of uni as a grad. If you've enjoyed this, please like and subscribe for more content.